Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Lisa and today I want to guide you through the wide range of possible applications when working with our proprietary Strep-tag technology, in particular with proteins. Let's go. The Strep-tag technology can be used for various applications. How the general principle behind this works has already been explained in another video and you can find the link in the video description below. It can generally be used for targeting proteins, cells, our exosomes, and when working with proteins or protein purification, the protein of interest needs to be connected to one of our tags. For cells or exosomes, you can choose between different surface marker specific antibody fragments, which are all connected to our twin strep tag, and these are called FAP straps. The approach for cells has already been described in another video, and you will also find the link in the description below. But today, and now we want to focus on the different possibilities of the Strep-tag technology for protein production and assay applications. One very important aspect of the Strep-tag technology for proteins is the availability of different tags, the Strep-tag 2 and its twin versions, the twin Strep-tag, and the two engineered strep-avidin variants, Streptactin and its high affinity variant, Streptactin XT. Different combination of tag and ligand result in different affinities, and this is the basis of the broad range of possible applications. When combining Streptactin and Streptactin 2, a micromolar affinity is achieved, making protein purification possible. If a higher affinity is needed, either tag or ligand can be exchanged, increasing the affinity to a nanomolar range, and thus besides purification, also detection is easily possible. For some applications, an even higher affinity is required. This can be achieved by using Streptactin XT in combination with a twin Streptag, leading to a picomolar affinity and also making more analytical applications like immobilization possible. You can choose yourself which combination you want to use according to your needs, of course. But now let's go into more details what kind of opportunities you have. At IBA, we offer products covering the whole protein production and assay workflow, from cloning to expression to purification and finally to further downstream analysis. But let's start at the very beginning of our protein production workflow with tools for cloning and expression. We offer more than 100 cloning and expression vectors for E. coli, mammalian cells, yeast or baculovirus, so for insect cells, and they all have different properties. These include, for example, the tags and their orientation. So you can choose from the twin strep tag or the strep tag 2 in combination with, for example, the his tag or the flag tag. Of course, the properties also depend on your protein of interest. Does it need to be secreted? Is a protein cleavage site required? But the vectors we offer are optional. So you can also work with your system you're familiar with and only integrate the strep tag 2 or the twin strep tag sequence into it. It is similar with the expression system. You can either work with our mammalian expression system, the MAXI system, which is optimized especially for high throughput mammalian expression and also efficient for Streptag purification, or you can use your own one. The choice is again up to you. Now we come to the next step in your protein workflow, the purification. Due to the highly specific selection and the resulting purity of target proteins, affinity-based systems like ours have become the flagship method of protein purification. Therefore, we provide several resins, either coupled with Streptactin or Streptactin XT, which all are applicable for Streptag 2 and twin Streptag fusion protein purification. The protein purification cycle varies between these two variants, but both serve the same goal: simple one-step protein purification without the need of tedious optimization to receive highly pure and fully functional proteins. As an example, I will guide you through the purification cycle of Streptactin XT. The first step is the application of your lysate. In this step, your target protein binds to the ligand, as you can see here, but all other host proteins are also present. To remove them, the physiological washing step follows, removing them, and then the competitive elution follows. If working with Streptactin XT, an elution buffer containing biotin is applied. Since biotin is added in excesses, it will replace the target protein and the protein is eluted in a very specific way. Because of the differences in the biotin binding pocket between streptactin and streptactin XT, different elution buffers are required. After your protein of interest has been purified, it is ready for further downstream applications. No removal of the peptide tag is required because they are composed of balanced amino acid sequences and the protein structure or activity is not influenced. After the elution, you don't have to throw the resin away because it can be simply regenerated for several times. Again here, for the regeneration, streptactin and streptactin XT require different buffers. Now that you've learned how protein purification works, you may wonder if it's also suitable for your protein of interest. So in the following, we want to answer the question, which proteins can be purified? In theory, all proteins having a Strep-tag 2 or a twin Strep-tag are suitable for purification based on the Strep-tag technology. And also, for example, biotin-related proteins can be purified. Besides the purification of classic proteins, the Strep-tag system can also be used for challenging proteins, like metalloproteins, membrane proteins, low-abundant proteins, which then might require working with streptactin XT, and even protein complexes with multiple subunits can be purified. A high tolerance towards different buffers and additives facilitates working with these different protein classes. So for example, if your target protein needs a specific buffer composition, like HAPIs or node gelatin agents like EDTA, the buffers can be easily adapted accordingly. After your protein has been successfully purified, it is ready to be used for further downstream application. And on the next slides, I will give you an overview what kind of analytic application this includes. With the Strep-tag technology, various methods for staining and detection to realize, for example, quantification of proteins from diverse samples are possible. These techniques include Western blots, enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay, short ELISA, immunohisto and immunocytochemistry, and also flow cytometry. It is very common to use antibodies for these different methods, and therefore you find Strep-tag-specific antibodies within our products. But besides antibodies, we also offer solutions with streptactin or streptactin XT conjugates, which can also be used as detection reagents. Besides relatively simple staining, we also offer innovative tools for biomolecular interaction analysis. They allow the determination of protein concentrations, as well as the analysis of affinities and kinetics of specific proteins, for example, to other proteins, to DNA, RNA, or cells. Pull-down assays, for example, not only focus on single proteins, but also on molecules which are attached to the target protein. Surface plasmon resonance, or short SPR, is an optical biosensor application for direct, real-time, and label-free measurements. Biolayer interferometry, or short BLI, like SPR, is a label-free optical biosensing technology for analyzing biomolecular interactions, for example, between antigen and antibody. It is in real time and allows quantification of the binding strength and kinetics. Especially SPR and BLE are suitable for high throughput applications. As mentioned before, combinations of tag and ligand resulting in different affinities are required, and for interaction analysis, working with a high affinity between streptactin XT and the twin streptag is recommended. Besides these examples, there are also even more applications possible. If you want to learn more about these, we have added some links for further information in the video description below. After having you guided through the whole protein production and assay application workflow, we are now already at the end of this short presentation. So thank you for joining, and if you want to learn more, feel free to visit our website, follow us on different social media channels, and if there are open questions, contact us and we will be happy to help.